To GIS Madras. So today we are going to see the basic tools which is essential for beginners who are new to the platform ArcGIS. So I'm going to just highlight the few important and necessary tools which are useful in visualizing and manipulating of data. So first we are going to see how to open the ArcMap. So just go to the option search. From this, type ArcMap. So this is how we are going to open the data. We have to just type ArcMap. You can see here, if you type Arc, there are three kinds of applications available: Arc Catalog, Arc Scene, Arc Administrator. We need to just go to the option ArcMap. So the next thing is that we are going to add data. That is the second thing. So I'm going to show you both adding of raster and vector data. So you can see here, this is a button which is used for adding data. So this is a vector data. You can see here, this is a vector kind of data. I'm going to just add it here. You can just visualize it here. And the next thing is that I'm going to add raster data. So you can see here I have added the data, but it isn't showing in the display. So just don't be panic. Go to the option zoom to the layer so that the data will be displayed. So you can also use the add data option using this option, where we need to go to the option file from the add data and just add it once again. So this is another option. So if you remove the tick mark, the data will be automatically removed from the display, but it will be still there in the background. So now we are going to see the third process. So using of standard table toolbar. Okay, so before going into it, so how to add this toolbar? So just right click here, and you can see your tick mark option in the left hand side. If you need to enable a tool, you have to just click it so that it will be added to the display. Like that, you can add this tool, which is really important for various analysis visually. So that is a standard table toolbar. This is the toolbar which is available here. So what are the functions from this tools? So you can see here, if you click here, this is for creating a new arc map. So the next thing is that you can see a folder like thing. This is for opening the MXT file. So you can ask me, what is MXT file? This is a kind of format which is being used in ArcGIS. If you are saving a file, it is basically shows as an MXT file. So you can just browse it and open it. So the next thing is that you can see here, this is for saving the progress of the work. If you just click it, it will be asking where to save. You can just specify the title and just save it. And the next thing is that print option. So this is a for printing the layout maps or displays. So the next thing is that you can see here, this is for pasting of data. So I'm going to just show you, for example, I'm adding a vector data here, and if you just right click here, just copy it, and you can see the paste option. You just click it, so you can see a copy of it. Simple. So the next thing is that just for undoing the mistakes which I have done previously, and redo it, undo it. This is the basic of that tool. This is for adding data. So the field which is been near to the add data is the scale of the map. For example, I'm going to just zoom out and show you the. You can show the difference in the scale of the map. You can just specify the scale here, so that the map will be changing automatically. So I'm going to show it for example. Okay, just see it is went inside the shape file. So the next thing is that this is for a editor toolbox, so which is a bit I'll show you in the coming videos. Okay, so the next thing is that you can see here, this is the tool which enables the table of contents. For example, the table of contents helps you to display the data. What is the what kind of data? You can just go into the data and just browse for much more details about the data properties, what it contains, spatially and attribute informations. So the table of contents is a can be. I'm just closing it. I'm just eliminating it here. You can just see here. This is for the tool. So the next thing is that Arc Catalog. This is like a file manager which we have been using in the computers. Like that, the Arc Catalog is for ArcGIS, which is used for exporting, putting data, dragging of data from one place to another place, and creating of geodatabase files, etc. So this is the another function which is for searching of data. I will elaborate it in a few seconds. This is Arc Toolbox, and this is for using Python. For coding, and this is Model Builder. So the next thing we are going to see is that using tools out here. This is the tool which is called as tools. So what is the basic function of it? You just click it, can zoom in, you can zoom out, as well as this is for using the panning of the data from one place to another place. You can just relatively go up and down, and this is for fitting into the data into the frame, and this is for zooming, zoom out, same process, zooming, zoom out, and this is for selecting your features. Yes, you can just see here, you can just select the feature. After the selecting the feature, you can just go to the option, you can just click on the vector, you can just copy it, you can export the data as well. So like that, that can be used, and this is for clearing the selection. Okay, so this is a simple tool for just manipulating out here and there or using the tools. So the next thing is that identity tool. So it tells you about this shapefile, what the shapefile contains, the fields which have been there. So the next thing is that it is a HTML pop-up, which is not necessary right now. After that, you can see the tool measure. This is used for measuring from one distance to another distance. You can just measure it using various units, and you can go for a polygon or a line. You can measure the area, etc. out of here. And this is for finding of data. So this is for marking X and Y coordinates. You can see here. It will be it is a bit advanced, so we'll be seeing it in the coming videos. So this is a tool. This is a small visualizer tool. You can also say it as a viewer, data inside data. You can just work it with this data. Example, if you don't want to get disturbed this data, you can just use this one in order to visualize the data more clearly in ArcMap. So please do subscribe this channel, and if you like the video, please give me a like, and please continue watching it.